For 35 years, the Govan graving docks have lay dormant. The site once served hundreds of ships, but most recently was part of the set for a Hollywood movie. But now, Dock Number 1 is preparing for a blockbuster comeback of its own.
Following the successful feasibility study we've done in 2020, we're very confident that the funding is in place and we will have an operational dry dock by the end of this year. My career started in Govan Shipbuilders and, you know, way back in the early 80s, so this place means a lot to me. I was in Govan working when this place was still operational, so really want to see it back in the map again.
It's not the first attempt to breathe new life into the dock. 4 years ago, an application for around 700 flats and leisure facilities at the site was dismissed, with concerns it didn't celebrate the area's history. But the new plans want to put history front and centre.
The dry dock will look like it looked back in its heyday, you know, employing a lot of people. It's a historic dry dock and will retain its existing features. We need to preserve the shipbuilding skills and the ship repairing skills that we have in Scotland, and there's been a decline in the training, the investment, and we're going to bring that back. We're going to train and we're going to invest in people in the local area and wider Scotland.
Liz Gardner is an expert on Glasgow's maritime history. She believes the return of ships and also jobs to the dry docks is a victory for Govan and the Clyde.
People want the heritage celebrated. They want that respected and sensitively developed. But more importantly, they want jobs. We believe it's in our DNA. It's sort of hardwired, that whole business of ships, shipbuilding, ship repair. We can smell it, we can feel it. That's who we want to be.
The aim is to have the dock back up and running by December, bringing an historic industry back to prime position on the River Clyde. Olly Dickinson, STV News, Glasgow.